A pleasant good morning to all. I am Mrs. V. Annalakshmi from Department of Computer Science in J.R.H. Annapakkam College for Women, Periyakulam. Now I am going to handle how to connect VB.NET application with Microsoft Access.
EDO.NET. The EDO.NET environment can be categorized into connected and disconnected environments. A connected environment requires a constant connection to transfer data between the client application and the data source. A disconnected environment retrieves data and performs modification without a constant connection to the data source. EDO.NET. The EDO.NET environment can be categorized into connected and disconnected environments. A connected environment requires a constant connection to transfer data between the client application and the data source. A disconnected environment retrieves data and performs modification without a constant connection to the data source. EDO.NET classes. EDO.NET classes can be categorized into two types. One is for disconnected classes, another one is for connected classes. In disconnected classes, it contains data set, data table collection, data table it have data row collection, data column collection, and constraint collection. In the connected classes, in .NET data provider, it supports data adapter. It will supports the select command, insert command, update command, delete command. Finally, the data reader, it goes to the command and it goes to the connection. Overall, all the details are stored in the data store. EDO.NET objects. EDO.NET objects have the following objects, such as connection object. Connection object that represents a connection to the database. Second one for command object that represents the, it allows us to execute a SQL statement or a stored procedure. And third one for data reader, it is a read-only and forward-only pointer into a table to retrieve records. And fourth one is for data set object. It can hold several tables and relationships between tables. And the final one is for data adapter. This is the object. It is used to pass the data between the database and the data set. Data providers. In VB.NET, it supports the following data providers. ODBC provider. ODBC is nothing but open database connectivity. It is a driver manager. It's used for relational databases. And the next one for OLEDB provider. OLEDB is nothing but it is an object linking and embedding database. It is an interfaces that provides applications with uniform access to data stored in diverse information sources or data stores. Next one for MS Access. MS Access is the database which can be stored in the extension with .accdb. And the next one for SQL Server Provider and Oracle Data Provider, etc. Using ODBC driver. In Windows 7, if you go to the ODBC driver and then goes to Control Panel and select Administrative Tools, select Data Source ODBC. There are three types of data source names are available, such as User DSN, System DSN, and File DSN. User DSN is nothing but it only usable by you and only on the machine currently using. System DSN, anyone using the machine can use. File DSN, it can be copied and used by other computers with the same driver installed. How to connect Access database using OLEDB. From the Server Explorer, you can right click the Add Connection and choose Microsoft Access database file, that is OLEDB, then browse for the database where the data are available. Next, choose the test connection. Once all the details are finished, the test connection will indicate it is succeed. Next, go to the tools or connect to the database.
How to connect Access database using ODBC.
From the Server Explorer, you can right click Add Connection, then click Change, then Microsoft Access ODBC Data Source. From that, you can select DSN from the drop down list box, then choose the test connection. Once if you finished all these test cases, it indicates test connection succeed, then click OK. Three ways to create ADO.NET objects. The first step, automatically generated when creating data bound form using the form wizard, and second one using data adapter wizard, and third one is using code. If you are using the code, means it shows the example, then the string connection equal to the provider name microsoft.ace.oledb 12.0, and the data source where you can store the database, that is the Microsoft Access database. Next, OLEDB connection objects, that we can indicate the string connection. Data binding. Data binding is nothing but we want to connect the data from the database. It connects a control or property to one or more data elements. It have two bindings. One is for simple binding, another one for complex binding. In simple binding, it uses simple binding to display a field value in controls that show data bindings in the property window, such as text box or label. In complex binding, to bind more than one field to controls such as data grid and list box, use the controls data source and data member to bind the data. Automatically generating data bound form. Creating a form with ADO.NET objects and data bound controls to display and update the information in a data set. For the step 1, add a new data source. In step 2, select the controls for table fields. For example, click the drop down list next to the table's name, then data grid view and details. In step 3, drag the table to the forms. Using binding source object to do the binding and navigation. It is an object that keeps track of position that indicates the current row of the data source. It supports the following properties: data source and data member. The methods of move first, move last, move next, move previous, and add new, allow edit, end edit, current, and remove current. Bind controls to binding source object. Configure adapter and generate data set. Add binding source object to the form. It use binding source object's property window to set its data source and data member properties to the data set object and table object. Set controls data binding property to the binding source object. Use binding source objects move next, move previous methods. Add a move next button using the binding source dot move next. Then add a move previous button using the command of binding source name dot move previous. Dataset and data adapter. Dataset object. A dataset object can hold several tables and relationships between tables. Data adapter. This is the object used to pass the data between the database and the data set. It is an object with SQL, select, insert, update, and delete commands. Thanks for watching. Hope you understand this concept.